Hi, very good morning, Varanda. Let us come to 9th biology. So, apart from that 9th class biology, already we have completed 7 different concepts in the previous classes. Now, it's time to discuss about that the 8th chapter, challenges in improving agricultural products. So, once again, I repeat the topic. Challenges means what are the difficulties, what are the problems while we are doing this agricultural practice in their fields. Actually, the farmers are facing a lot of problems while they are cultivating the plants. So, even though how they have to overcome these problems and how to increase high yielding, high production. So, that is our topic. So, before coming to the topic, just we have to link up these topic to that 8th class, 8th chapter, production and management of food from the plants. So, already 8th class itself, the biology, it's a branch of life sciences like plants and animals. Exclusively, we are studying in a separate part that we call as a biological science, short form biology. So, there you learn about different branches like cytology, histology, like sense organs, like taxonomy, different branches of ethology, like animal behavior. So, we already completed a different branches of biology. One of the important part of biology is regarding the agriculture, means cultivation of the plants. So, first, just we have to connect the topic to the 8th class previous knowledge, and we have to continue the topic in a 9th class. So, let us come to the first 8th class. 8th class, 8th chapter, production and management of food from the plants. So, what do you mean by production? Obviously, the plants are producers because of their photosynthesis process. So, plants utilize these simple inorganic compounds like carbon dioxide and water. They have to produce that starch or carbohydrate. Starch is nothing but a type of carbohydrate. Not only carbohydrates, proteins, fats, these pulses, cereals, grains, so fruits, vegetables. So, all the plant products are produced by this photosynthesis process. So, that the plants are called as producers. So, the production is certainly depends upon the proper management. So, in 8th class already learn about production is depends upon the proper management. What is meant by management? While practicing this agricultural practices, each and every step is very, very important. Each and every part, each and every task in agricultural practice plays a vital role, from sowing to storing. See, let us come to the previous 8th class topic. Now, just we have to recall, try to recall that one. First one is, what is meant by agriculture? It's not a new trend. It is a culture from the primitive man to modern man. Even today, 60% of our Indian population, main occupation is agriculture. Next, see, agriculture or cultivation. Vyavasayam chedu ledha saagubadi chedu. Mokkalni saagubadi chedu ledha vyavasayam chedu. Next, apart from that, first word is crop. What is mean by a crop? In 8th class, we learned that the plants which we are growing in a large number, the same type of plants which are growing in a large number, especially which is useful for us as a food products. So, such type of plants are cultivated is called as a crop. Generally, we are having two types of crops. One is the short-term crops and long-term crops. So, based on that crop life cycle, from sowing to harvesting, some plants it takes only below 100 days. From sowing to harvesting, it takes only below 100 days. These type of crops are called as short-term crops. For example, see, paddy, wheat, maize, these are called as short-term crops. Some type of crops, they need more than 180 days, more than 6 months. So, such type of crops are called as long-term crops. For example, sugarcane, coconut, mango, these are called as long-term crops. See, so in 8th class, we learn about production means producing. How the plants are produced with the proper management, with the proper protection, with the proper care, with the proper practice. So, such type of practices are called as agricultural practices. So, apart from crop, already learn about our India is having 3 types of seasonal. changes. That is called as a Kharif season, king of the rains in Arabic word, king of the rains from June to October. So November to March or February we are having the winter season. So king of rains is a Kharif season, rain season. Next Rabi is a winter season. Next we are having the third crop in India, that is called as a Kharif summer crop, that we call as a Jabid, like watermelon. Next, agricultural practices starts from sowing to storing. First one is preparation of the soil. I mean that before monsoons, the farmer have to prepare their field in a preparation. That means plowing and leveling. Before sowing the seeds, it must be prepared. That is called the preparation of the soil by plowing and leveling. Next, to sowing the seeds by manual or seed drills. Next, applying the manure, plants require some more nutrients in the form of NPK or some micronutrients. See, next one is facilitate the water. Irrigation supply is very important. Next, remove the weeding. Unwanted plants are removed. Next, crop harvesting. After completion of the fully grown plant, that means when the crop is coming to yielding, at that time we are going to harvest, cut the plants, and we have to store next crop, up to next crop. So this is the previous knowledge what we have to gain from this 8th class 8th chapter, production and management of food from the plants. Now coming to the 9th class 8th chapter, challenges in improving agricultural products. So as a farmer, they are doing this agricultural practices, each and every step, each and every task, it is a challenging factor. Why? Because see, food production is not at all equal to population growth. How can we understand this concept? By based on that agriculture department of statistical report of past 5 to 6 decades. So from 1951 to 2020, we are having 70 years experience. So by this 7 decades or 5 to 6 decades of statistical information by agriculture department, it is clearly indicated that the food production, of food, it is not at all equivalent, it is not at all to meet the demand of overpopulation. So I mean that food production is not at all sufficient to the population growth. Why? Because so many reasons are there. First one is overpopulation. Population is increasing, but according to the population growth, the land area is not increasing, or food production is not increasing. And moreover, decreasing the land area. And in addition to that, some natural disasters, like recently in Hyderabad, how the floods can damage this entire livelihood in agricultural loss. So, like floods. Next to seed crisis. So many reasons are there. Reasons might be different, like these, all these reasons are causing to the challenging factor of agricultural products. So improving agricultural products is a challenging factor because of all these reasons. Even though as a farmer, they have to overcome these problems by using some techniques. Those are called as how to overcome this situation, and moreover, how to produce high-yielding varieties, high-yielding grains. Yes, to get the high yield, we are having the three types of methods are being used. How to overcome this situation? According to the textbook concern, we are having the three types of methods. The first one is to get high yield. Three types of methods are being used. First one is improving the high yielding crop varieties. What is meant by high yielding crop varieties? Means hybrid varieties. Hybrid varieties. So as we shown in the textbook, figure number 2A 108, page number, we are having the two clear differences between the same grains that we call as a zoar. Generally, when we choose a hybrid variety, it is having a more size, good color, good taste, good in a attractive shape. So these are called as a high yielding crop varieties. By using HYV seeds, high yielding varieties or hybrid varieties by genetic engineering and biotechnology. So the latest technology like gene therapy or genetic engineering or biotechnology, these are the advantages of the scientific technology which we are inserting in the agriculture. So that we call as a HYV seeds or hybrid varieties. Next, see, we are having a case study. Means it's a real story of one of the farmer. He is calling as a ideal farmer or a model farmer because of he received that award, a prestigious award of that ideal farmer in an annexer phase. So when we move to that annexer, we are having a real story of Gudivada Nagaratnam Naidu. See, this is the story of a successful story or a successful person, a successful farmer who has succeeded in that overcome these problems. So it is a challenging factor. Of course, it is a challenging factor. He faced that and he succeeded by using his Sri Vari. So he got that award by his government of India by producing the high yielding varieties like a Sri Vari. Sri means system of rice intensification. It is a type of paddy. We are having different varieties of in our paddy. For example, Molagal Pulu or Jilakara or Mudipidi Pillu, Sunnalu. So we are having the local language in the different varieties. But apart from that, he is using Sri Vari. It requires a less amount of water, but production is nearly triple. Three times we are getting the benefit. So that he is using the Sri Vari. So that he is considered as the ideal or model farmer. Next, we move to the improving the high yielding varieties. First method. Second method is called as using high yielding management methods. So first one is seed. First of all, we are giving much importance to the seed selection. Certainly the seed is certified and quality seeds. Already you know that how we have to select the good seeds in the 8th class. The seeds which are having a good color, good shape and size, and good weight, more weight. So those seeds we have to select for next cropping, or we can go to the high yielding crop varieties like these hybrid seeds. Next we move to the using high yielding management methods. So what management methods we have to follow to get high yielding? The first one is irrigation. Certainly there is a relation to the water and the plant growth. Already we in the 7th class of nutrition plants, one government conducted an experiment or an activity which is related to plant growth, body mass and the water. So the fields, when we compare to the sufficient amount of water, and the other one is not have any water supply. So there is a clear difference between water and the paddy collection. Next to plant nutrients. So the plant requires nutrients. While we are sowing these seeds in the fields, the seedling started and germination. So the growing plant requires some nutrients in the form of NPK, means nitrogen, phosphorus, potash, like macronutrients, or the micronutrients like iron, zinc, manganese, boron, copper, molybdenum and chromium. So these are the micronutrients, and the nitrogen, phosphorus, potash, they are required in larger quantities like macronutrients. How we are taking the carbohydrates, proteins, fats as a macronutrients, vitamins and minerals also as a micronutrients. In the same manner, the plant also requires macro and micronutrients. Next one is called as nutrients in the soil. This is different. Plant requires macro and micronutrients for proper growth. So after growing, so they are giving yielding, means grains, they produce some more grains or cereals. So as a food item, while we are taking these food grains, again we are getting these nutrients to our body. After death, plants and animals, they have to decompose, and these nutrients are replenished to the soil. Again the soil getting these nutrients. So there is a chain reaction, replenish, get back. These nutrients are get back to the man by food items. After completion of their life cycle, again these nutrients are mixed in the soil. So this is very clear in the last chapter, biogeochemical cycles. Bio means life. After completion of our life, certainly we have to decompose by bacteria and fungi in the soil surface. So our nutrients are reaches to the soil. Again the soil is having supply to the nutrients to the plant. So that is called as a biogeochemical cycle. Nutrients in the soil. Next one is crop rotation. So for example, see, we are having two seasons. Kharif season, of course, we are having a lot of amount of water because of monsoons. We can cultivate paddy crop, but certainly second crop must be, it should be in a pulses. So whenever we are taking the pulses crop as a second crop, if we are cultivating these pulses in our field, like rhizobium bacteria, which is the soil bacteria, nitrogen fixing bacteria, the atmospheric nitrogen can fix in that rhizobium bacteria, can fix in the groundnut root nodules. So we no need to give any extra amount of nitrogen or nitrates are nitrogen fertilizers to the two these groundnut crop. Why? Because these nitrogen fixing bacteria can help to the conversion of atmospheric nitrogen to nitrates. This is called as a symbiosis. So what do you mean by symbiosis? The mutual beneficial. So rhizobium bacteria, see here already you have idea about the symbiosis. Symbiosis is nothing but the bacterium which lives in the groundnut root nodules, that is called as a rhizobium bacteria. It is also called as nitrogen fixing bacteria, which helps to conversion of atmospheric nitrogen to nitrate and gives to the plant. So by using this nitrate, plant grow properly and produce the high yielding. So these nutrients are utilized for proper growth of bacteria. Both are getting a mutual beneficial. So such process is called as a symbiosis. Symbiosis. See, this is called as a crop rotation. Main crop is a paddy crop or a commercial crop. Second must be in pulses, which can increase the soil fertility by this symbiosis process. Next, mixed cropping, cultivation of mixed cropping. For example, see, in our textbook we are having some beautiful combination like haldi means turmeric and cabbage, groundnut with green gram. So at a time in a field we are cultivating several types of crops. More than one crop is called as a polyculture or a mixed cropping. Certainly it helps to improve the economy of the farmer. Next, organic manure means natural manure. Natural means the manure which is produced by the decaying of plant and animal waste by decomposing method. So organic manure, nowadays the public or the people which are aware about the importance of organic fertilizers, organic farming, organic vegetables, because the chemical fertilizers which causes to the damage of the livelihood as well as the it causes to the several diseases. Okay, so organic manure means natural manure which is prepared by this decaying of plant and animal waste. I mean that cow dung or animal excretes which should be decomposed, and they have to prepare that coconut pit or these vermicompost like this. Organic manure. Next, green manure. Sometimes the farmers which are developing some crops and they have to plow back in that soil, that we call as some crops are example basil and kulti. Pilipesra. Generally, in our farmers, pilipesra like short-term crops are cultivating, and they have to plow back. Why? Because the nutrients which are present in the plant, it should be replenished to the soil by this plowing back of this green manure like crops. Example, see, this is called as a green manure. Pachi rotta. I mean that pachi erul. So, in the only nutrients and you soil can reach out on the root. This is called pilipesra, bersam, kulti, sunhen. Short term crops ni cultivate chesi dantlo manam niyasam baga plowing chesi. This is called as a green man. Next, soil testing. So before sowing the seeds, which type of crop we are going to cultivate, what type of seeds we are selecting, so what are the nutrients ratio is present in the soil, by using this soil testing centers. Those are pariksha kendralu. So when we visit these soil testing centers, when we are giving the sample soil collection to the soil testing center, they have to test the soil and they can give the values of this macro and micronutrients. Based on the data, we have to apply the manure in the field to get a better yield, better results. Next, this is the helping of a soil testing center. So soil testing center can test the soil. So based on that values, we are going to add or remove the nutrients in that particular soil, in a particular crop, in a particular field, particular type of soil. Next one is vermicompost. As we know that the earthworms are the soil friendly or eco-friendly, the farmer friendly earthworms. Insects are called as earthworms. So actually it is a case study of Vindhyamooru of Bomaraju. So Vindhyamooru mandal is very near to that Atmapur. It is a real story. The farmers which are belongs to the Vindhyamooru, the farmers are hesitated by using these chemical fertilizers, and these chemical fertilizers continuously they are using this 20 years. The soil health is completely damaged. The lands are turn into the waste lands. So they have to hesitate these supplying of these chemical fertilizers, and after that they have to realize they are seeking the soil health. So while the soil aarogyam drushti pettukoni, they have to meet the DOT, that means agricultural officer, along with the agriculture field officer and the DOT centers. So DOT center means Department of Field Communications of agriculture field officers. So with the help of these agricultural officers and DOT centers, they started the vermicompost. See, these are called as earthworms. The earthworms, which are the farmer friends, they are using this natural manure, organic manure. As we discussed, organic manure is the best manure when compared to chemical fertilizers. So these are the sheds which they are making for using this vermicompost. They are adding this vermicompost. So at the beginning, they need 40 to 45 days time, but after first time their collection, every year minimum 6 times. So every 2 months or every 1.5 month they are getting this vermicompost. When they are using instead of these chemical fertilizers, these vermicompost, they are getting this better results. So this is the successful story of case study of these Vijayamuru farmers by successful in this manner. That is called as a vermicompost. So they succeeded by this method. So they have to realize the importance of soil health. They are not seeking only the food production, they are seeking the soil health. So by applying this vermicompost, they are getting the better results compared to chemical fertilizers. So this is the information regarding the vermicompost. So A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. Next we move to Panchagavya. So Panchagavya means 5 ingredients. So these 5 ingredients are very important for better results. See, Panchagavya, actually cow milk, curd, ghee, dung and cow urine. So cow milk, curd, ghee, dung and urine. These are the 5 ingredients of cow. So first of all, we have to take ghee and dung. We have to mix and we have to wait for 4 days. So first of all, we have to take ghee. Avu neeni, adhe vidhanga avu yokka pad ni teesukoni 4 days for mix chesi alage unchali. Next we have to add milk, curd and urine. So other 3 ingredients we have to add later 4 days. So first of all, we have to mix the combination of ghee and dung. After 4 days we are adding these 3 remaining ingredients and we have to add kallu, taati kallu, and moreover we are adding this coconut water and sugar cane juice. So charakarasamu, copper neeku plus taati kallu ni add chesi pakkana unchali. Tarvata manam daniki banana paste. So బాగా మగ్గిపోయినటువంటి ఆ బనానా పేస్ట్ ని యాడ్ చేసి ఒక 10 డేస్ పాటు బాగా వెయిట్ చేసి మార్నింగ్ ఈవినింగ్ బాగా స్టిర్ చేయాలి. కలిపెట్టి ఒక 10 డేస్ పాటు ఉంచినట్టయితే దెన్ వీఆర్ గెటింగ్ ద పంచగవ్య. బట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎన్ స్ప్రే టైప్ ఆఫ్ ఫర్టిలైజర్. జస్ట్ వీ హావ్ టు యూజ్ 3%. సో రిమైనింగ్ 97% ఇట్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ అనదర్ మెటీరియల్. దట్ మీన్స్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ వీఆర్ యూజింగ్ పౌడర్ లైక్ సబ్స్టెన్స్ ఆర్ ద వాటర్ కంటెంట్. Just 3% we are using for that high yielding. So that is the importance of, that is the advantage of these Panchagavya. So this is the natural ingredients, that is the value of the cow ingredients which are adding to that fertilizer as a Panchagavya. Next we are going to that organic farming. Organic fertilizers are different, organic farming is different. So organic farming is, so we are using this organic materials, organic fertilizers, and we are cultivating the land. So we are cultivating our land by using these organic methods that we call as a organic farming. Of course, at the beginning, chemical fertilizers which gives better results when compared to organic fertilizers or natural fertilizers. But after 20 to 30 years, certainly it can decrease and it can damage the soil. This is called as a organic farming. Next, chemical fertilizers. As we said that NPK fertilizers, that is called as a chemical fertilizers. So instead of chemical fertilizers, we can select that vermicompost, Panchagavya and some other crop rotation or mixed cropping. So these are the alternative methods instead of these chemical fertilizers for better results and better yielding, and we are seeking the soil health. So next class we are going to discuss about that the differences between the chemical fertilizers and biofertilizers. Are artificial and natural fertilizers. Next, what is the difference between the manure and fertilizers? Next, we are going to discuss about the last step, that is called as a crop protective methods. So, children, regarding these challenges in improving agricultural products, we are having the three types. First one is HYV seeds, usage of hybrid varieties. Next, proper management methods from A to L. So total we are having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 methods. So 12 steps are there. By using these 12 steps, we are getting the better results. So after producing this better yielding crop, we have to protect our crop from the weeds, means unwanted plants, harmful insects, and some plant diseases. So these steps we are going to discuss in another video. Thank you, children. Thank you for watching this video.